So a question I get a lot is, what is a SNP? And what does it mean to me? Well, a SNP stands for single nucleotide polymorphism. But let's take a step back. Let us gain a foundation. What I want you to picture is the 3D representation of a gene, which looks like a ladder that has been twisted. So two spiraled strands that parallel one another. And in between each one of those strands are perpendicular lines or rungs on a ladder. Those rungs of the genetic ladder are made up of a pair of nucleotides. Nucleotides are adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine, each referenced in the code from their first letter, A, G, C, and T, respectively. So where does your code come from? It is inherited from your mother and your father. Imagine if you were spelling out a word like apple, and instead of spelling it A-P-P-L-E, you replaced one of the P's with an L. So you'd have A-P-L-L-E. Well, you may pronounce that word differently now that it's spelled differently. So when coming back to your genetic code, that alteration, the L replacing the P, is considered a SNP or a variant. In our body, the significance of this error, or like I said earlier, variant, is that it may change the downstream outcome, like in the spelling example, pronouncing the word differently. But in the cell, this variant alters a protein and its enzymatic function or reaction, decreasing or enhancing its ability. This alteration, when expressed, can lead to potential problems like decreased ability to detoxify chemicals or hormones or different pharmaceuticals, or other toxicants, or may indicate that you require a different form of a specific nutrient to alter, normalize, or enhance that enzyme's response. Looking at SNPs is an exciting, cutting-edge science, and as we continue to learn more every day, this data will continue to help guide practitioners, and more importantly, you, to make decisions that align with your genetics, to achieve your goals and pursue a limitless potential. Mapping out the SNPs that we understand can reveal amazing things from your risk factors of developing a certain disease, and then an action plan on how to modify or reduce that risk. Learn what types of foods like proteins, carbohydrates, and fats would benefit you, your biochemistry, to the type of micronutrients you may need to consume to protect your mitochondria, to what type of exercise or athletic event your body would most succeed, all the way to figuring out whether you possess certain SNPs that have been associated with living a longer, healthier life, and a lot more. The future of healthcare, the future of the way we as physicians deliver recommendations, and the way you implement strategies in your life will change from focusing on the average individual to focusing on you, your genetics, your environment, your lifestyle, food, water, relationships, light, mindset, and more. It is an exciting time to be alive and realize that with this information, you can succeed in exceeding. This is Dr. Rudy Mueller from Slimitless. I really hope this helps you understand exactly what a SNP is. And I just want to remind you to live happy, live healthily, and affect others positively. Thanks.